Hey Simmers, if you're having trouble with submitting your content to CurseForge, here's some bullet points you need to know. Start by hitting the Start a Project button. Select your game, in this case, The Sims 4, and then the right category, Create a Sim, Rooms and Lots, etc. Then, choose a name for your project. The project's name is important, so make sure you choose a unique name that describes your project as clearly as possible. Try to avoid version numbers or including the project's category in its name. For example, instead of Overwolf T-shirt mod by the awesome CurseForge Boy 123, try Overwolf T-shirt. Next, fill in the summary, a simple one-line explanation about your creation. No extras, no links, no version numbers, just a basic summary. The description is where you can write as many details as you like. Embed images and videos, share your socials, and invite users to join your community. Choose the license, and if you're remaking an existing project, please make sure the license of the original project allows it. After that, select the accurate primary category and specific subcategory your creation belongs to. Now, it's time to choose the project's avatar image. This is your project's visual representation, so make sure it's cool and stands out. This image should be at least 400 by 400 pixels on a scale of 1 to 1. Your project's avatar cannot stay blank and should be an original image that wasn't used on CurseForge yet. As long as your project is a visual object and not a script-based mod, it must have an avatar image and at least one screenshot image. Visual projects without the required images won't be approved. Now that your project page is ready, it's time to upload your files. Please, upload the project files as a zip file only. No RAR files, no RAR files changed manually to zip, just zip. Make sure you're choosing either beta or release on the release type. Alpha release means it will stay hidden and no one will be able to find it. Also, make sure you're selecting the exact game version and needed expansion packs required for your project to work properly. And that's it. Your project will now head over to moderation, where several automated and manual processes are run to make sure your project follows our standards. If your project requires changes, you will receive more specific feedback. If you're having trouble or feel like your mod takes too long to approve, feel free to contact us on our Discord channel, and our team will help you with anything you need.